वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग कैडेट्स, वी आर इन चैप्टर नंबर 5, चैप्टर जुडिशियरी। इन द लास्ट वीडियो क्लास डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रोल ऑफ जुडिशियरी and the role of judiciary, the dispute resolution discussed, and we also discussed about judicial review, discussed about what is the meaning of judicial review, the power of a judiciary to review the laws passed by the legislature, power of the so we discussed in the last video session. And the third role of judiciary is upholding law and enforcing fundamental rights. Who protects the fundamental rights given to the citizens by the Constitution? So it is a duty of the judiciary or the Supreme Court and High Court, it's the duty of judiciary to protect the laws passed by the legislature and to protect the fundamental rights of the citizen. Every citizen of India can approach Supreme Court or the High Court if they believe that their fundamental rights have been violated. For example, in a class of 7th book, you read about Hakim Sheikh, an agricultural laborer who fell from a running train and injured himself. So, when he was denied the treatment by the various hospital, then he finally approached the court of law, and the court of law or the judiciary gave ordered or direction to the West Bengal government to pay him compensation and for the loss which he suffered, as well as asked the government to come up with the action plan what they will do henceforward in such cases. Okay. Today, let us discuss about another major topic, that is about independence of judiciary, or what is an independent judiciary is all about. When we discussed about three organs of the government, namely legislature, executive and judiciary. So what discussion here is that out of the three out of the three organs of the government, judiciary should be independent. Now, what do you mean by independent of judiciary? That means judiciary should not be controlled by neither by legislature nor by the executive. So imagine a situation in which a powerful politician has encroached on land belonging to your family. Within this judicial system, the politician has a power to appoint and dismiss a judge from his office. When you take this case to the court, The judge is clearly partial to the politician. The control that politicians hold over the judges does not allow the judge to take an independent decision. This lack of independence would force the judge to make all the judgments in favor of politicians. Although we often hear of a rich and powerful people in India trying to influence the judicial process, the Indian Constitution protects against this kind of situation by providing for independent judiciary. So by providing for an independent judiciary, it is very, very essential so that judiciary can protect the rights of citizens. One aspect of this independence of judiciary is separation of powers. So what is the meaning of separation of power? This, as you read in chapter 1, the key feature of the Constitution, what this means here is that other branches of government, the legislature and the executive, cannot interfere in the work of the judiciary. So what do you mean by separation of power? Separation of power means the power is clearly divided and distributed between legislature, executive and judiciary. At the same time, it is ensured that neither legislature nor executive can interfere in the work of judiciary. Or in the simple words, the decision of the court should be independent, unbiased, or it should be based on the evidences, not on the basis of individual opinion. The court are not under the government and do not act on their behalf. For the above separation of work, it is also crucial that all judges in the High Court as well as the Supreme Court are appointed with a very little interference from these other branches of the government. Once appointed to this office, it is also very difficult to remove a judge. Now, what this entire statement says that the Constitution made it very clear that the judges appointed to the Supreme Court or the High Court purely on the basis of the merit, means their education qualification, their experience in their field. So it's purely on the basis of merit. Here, there's a less scope for a politician to interfere in the appointment procedure of a judge. Not only appointment procedure, legislature or executive has a less role, or rather no role, in which they can remove the judges from the power. The courts are not under the government and do not act on their behalf. So for the above separation of work, it is crucial that all judges in the High Court as well as the Supreme Court are appointed with a very little interference from these other branches of the government. Once appointed to this office, it is very difficult to remove a judge. It is very difficult to remove a judge. It is the independence of the judiciary that allows the court to play a central role in ensuring that there is no misuse of power by the legislature and the executive. So it is always said that there is no misuse of power by the legislature or by the executive. It is also play a crucial role in protecting fundamental rights of the citizen, because anyone can approach the court if they believe that their rights have been violated. So any person or any citizen can approach the court if he feels the government, let it be state government or central government, is denying his fundamental rights. So we completed discussion of the role of judiciary. The role of judiciary, the first one is dispute resolution. Dispute resolution. Second one is judicial review. Third one is enforcing the law and protecting fundamental rights. Enforcing law and protecting fundamental rights. And the what is independence of judiciary means separation of power. So power is separated. Power is separated. Legislature, executive, and judiciary. Among three organs of the government, power is separated. Now let us move to the next topic. Organizational structure of Supreme Court or the courts in India. What do you mean by organizational structures? Means how Indian judiciary is set up. That is what we are studying about organization structure. There are three different levels of the court in our country. There are several courts at the lower level, while there is only one at the apex level. So there are several courts in the lower level, that means in the munshif level or in taluk level, there are many courts. But if you reach the higher level, there's only one court at the apex level, that means in the top. The courts that most people interact with are what are called as subordinate or district courts. The courts that most people interact with are what are called as subordinate or district courts. So district courts or the lower courts are more. These are usually by the district or tehsil level or in the towns, and they hear many kinds of cases. Each state is divided into districts that are presided over by district judge. So, what is the basic structure of the court? In tehsil level or in a district level, each district is having one court which is called a district court. District Sessions Court. Okay. And district session court is presided by whom? By a district judge. Each state has a high court. So most of the states in India having a high court, except few, because northeastern states have only one high court. But other than few states, all other states are having a high court. Each state has a high court, which is the highest court of in the state. So, which is the highest court of appeal in the state? That is the High Court. Which is the highest court of appeal in the nation? That is Supreme Court. So, the highest court of appeal is in the state, it is High Court. At the top, is the Supreme Court that is located in New Delhi. So at the top we have Supreme Court located in New Delhi. And the Supreme Court is presided by CJI, that is Chief Justice of India. The Chief Justice of India The decision made by the Supreme Court are binding on other courts in India. So here, now please go through the topic once again. It is very clearly said that Supreme Court is the highest court of appeal in the country. Supreme Court is the highest court of appeal in the country. At the same time, decision taken by the Supreme Court is binding on the other courts, namely High Court and District Courts. So please go through the structure of the court. This is the structure of Indian court, that is the pyramidal structure. So you can see the structure of the court. Some stuck. Okay. So here you can understand the structure of the court. The structure of the court from the lower to highest court is that it resembles in a pyramidal shape. So having read the description about, now you can see here, you can locate this in the diagram, that is the highest court of appeal is the Supreme Court of India. Below Supreme Court, taluk courts are there. So below Supreme Court, taluk courts are, high courts are there. And below High Court, Taluk Court or the Tahsil Court or the District Courts are there. So, this is the structure of court in India. So, in India, we have the highest court of appeal, that is the Supreme Court of India. So the highest court of appeal is the Supreme Court of India, and here what you have to understand, the Supreme Court of India is the highest court of appeal in our country. Some problem when the begs me to. Anyhow, take care. I'll meet you in the next class. Thank you.